What's an unexpectedly well-paid job? If you have a strong stomach, cleaning up death and crime scenes pays very well and requires little education. UPS drivers can make close to 100k if you stay there long enough. Blew me away when I first heard that. YouTubers who just copy Reddit posts into a voice thing and then upload it with the text on the background. Edit. For those saying people who actually speak and make it unique aren't that bad. I agree. I still don't watch them, but I agree. My point is those YouTubers who literally just copy and paste text into a text-to-speech program they found on the internet. I was a bathroom attendant in a fancy restaurant. Made $100 a night in cash to do next to nothing. Mobile crane operator. Union guys pull over 200k and it's a trade that's pretty easy on the body. Garbage collectors in New York are paid up to $112k. A solid salary considering you don't even need a degree. Sounds like a nice fallback plan for me. There is a job in my country called chicken sixer. You're paid something like 10k euros permission to touch newborn chicks and determine their sex. Utility lineman. There is a developing shortage nationwide due to baby boom retirements. It's well paid base, but the overtime is fabulous. Ditch digger. Actually, directional boring. Guy I know was literally a ditch digger, but got into this by renting the specialized equipment just at the right time and right place. Fiber optic build out in the 1990s. He will also say that he made it simply by being reliable and trustworthy. I do not know exactly how much he makes, but he has an 80-foot sport fisherman. Probably cost $7-10 million, and he bought a $4 million property on a whim. Court reporting. Stenography is a tough skill to learn, but plenty of court reporters earn over $100k, and no college degree required, although most CRs will need to be certified. Airline dispatcher. A girl I dated many years ago I met because she was living in my town training to be an airline dispatcher. There are just a handful of schools that teach it. I had no idea what an airline dispatcher was, let alone how much money they get paid. Dispatchers at FedEx can make $150,000 per year or more. It also gives you a lot of options to advance at an airline, like being station chief at an airline. The girl I dated had a dream to one day be Air France station chief in Tahiti. I don't know if she made it or not. I don't know if this is true in other cities, but T and bus operators in Boston make bank. I've rarely met a higher paid, less engaged group of employees in my life, and I work in recruiting. Edit. Since this seems to have attracted some attention, here is an article on the subject of MBTA salaries. Underwater welding pays a tremendous amount. The only one I know personally retired comfortably in his 40s. I work at home as a closed captioner broadcaster for the news. I make my own schedule and make between $35 to $65 per hour depending on the job. Large investments to get started, but significantly worth the payout. I drive machinery in a coal mine in Australia. I make about 170k. Even our new trainees are paid pretty well. About $48 per hour. I think it ends up being close to 90-100k. Easy money for sitting on your ass in an air-conditioned cab. Power linemen make bank. Not a lot of people even know about it. Self-employed cleaning services. I don't know exactly what to call it. My parents started getting paid $35 an hour cleaning a community center to $50 from cleaning offices. My mom started it, then my dad joined in to help her with the hours and taking care of the house and kids. Eventually my mom got good contacts and started cleaning the offices of managers from factories, Sacramento politicians, and stuff alike. Can't express how proud I am of my mom. She turned all those itty Hispanic cleaning lady jokes into something bragworthy. Scrum masters in software development industry. They are paid six figures for basically setting up meetings and being cheerleaders. They don't have any responsibility for delivery of work, and they don't have any work beyond what I described. Update. I am talking about a dedicated scrum master who does absolutely nothing else but be a scrum master. Update 2. I agree with you when you say you hate that this position exists as an individual entity and do believe that having one person just do this is wasteful. Update 3. I am specifically referring to Scrum Masters. Project managers and engineering managers and POs are not included in this. Longshoreman. If you are a senior member of a union, you make absolute cake. $180k plus a year. I don't understand why every time this question is asked, a large percentage of the responses are skilled trades. The only reason I can come up with is the mindset in the education system that pushes every student toward white-collar jobs. Why are so many people surprised at the jobs that require a specialized knowledge? An apprenticeship most times, often as long as a bachelor's degree, an investment in tools, etc., is a decent paying job. In addition to that, tradesmen beat their bodies up, deal with nasty hazardous materials, cook in the sun, freeze in the winter, are greatly affected by the economy, and have a much higher at-work death rate than most jobs. Janitor in the public sector. Hot dog vendors can earn six figures in a year. In some states, corrections officers make insane money with just a get and willingness to work overtime. Edit. It says some states. Guys. Some. States. Collecting golf balls. Saw on the news a guy makes over $250,000 traveling around and using scuba gear getting golf balls. Technical writing. If you have the ability to take complex technical information and simplify it according to the reading audience, you can make well over $100k annually. People ridicule English degrees until they find out how much can be earned as a technical writer. At the right place waitressing. I got tipped $800 waitressing at a bowling alley for a team building company party. Plumbers. They can charge $100 an hour easy because people are stupid about regular things. Autopsy tech. I started out making $15 an hour in Illinois. Just need a high school diploma and the ability to not puke at the sight of blood and guts. I love that job. Only left because I needed surgery on my knee. I'd totally still be doing that if I lived in a town with a morgue now. But I live in the Alaskan bush. Anybody needing an autopsy just gets sent to Anchorage. Addendum. To everyone itching about $15 an hour being nothing. This was in 2009. Yeah, it probably isn't enough to have a family on, but I was a 19-year-old and it was my first job. Basically anything blue collar. Plumbers, electricians, heavy construction laborers, commercial truck drivers. The list goes on. An office job, but you're secretly on Reddit. IDK if surprising but one people don't think about. Selling ad space on local broadcast stations. I do it and make more than most families do in my area, and I'm at smaller market. Going into a medium one can put you well into six figures. Contractors for household moving companies with 18 wheelers can gross between 200 and 400k a year. Boiler operator. Get paid $35 an hour to play Skyrim on Switch while watching Netflix. Just have to find one that's all operator and no maintenance. I made BuzzFeed. Doorman at a big name hotel. Tips, 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 baby. I fix hospital beds. Will be making 100k within my first 2 years with full benefits. I also have full control over my hours. Trader Joe's managers. General managers of stores make $100,000 plus. Assistant store managers make $60,080 a year. Not bad for working grocery. Furry porn artist. Seriously. Furries will shovel out so much money for commissions and then tip on top of that. If you get a big enough following, it can be surprisingly well paid. CBP officer. At least at the northern border and airports. You sit in a booth and ask the same questions over and over again. Now and then you may end up referring someone to secondary based on suspicions, but another officer takes over at that point and you go back to your normal duties. Despite the job being law enforcement, it's incredibly safe. Especially in airports where you're already shielded by multiple layers of security. I've heard they can make 130k plus benefits after just a few years on the job. No college degree needed. I work as a lunch lady. I get school vacations off, summers off, and weekends. No nights, or even really afternoons. It's amazing. I also get benefits, and every year I get a raise. So between the money and the time off, The job is 100% worth it. Dog groomer. It's a weird industry, though, and a skill that really has to be learned hands-on. Grooming schools can be a good start, but I know great groomers that never went to school for it, and terrible groomers that spend thousands on classes. Just being good at handling dogs is the best foundation for success. It's not the easiest job in the world, it's largely commission-based, and you're lucky if you get any benefits out of it. But if you get enough practicing to be good at it and build up a loyal clientele base in a decently affluent area, it's good money. The haircuts I do range from $70 to $175, and I'm paid 50%, which averages out to around $30 to $35 an hour most days. Not everyone tips, but those that do usually tip $5 to $20 per dog, and because I do about 40 dogs in an average week, that's an extra couple hundred in my pocket. So if you don't mind working on your feet all day, sustaining repetitive motion injuries, not taking lunch breaks, dealing with insane customers, and picking it off dog buttholes, it's a good living. If you are from a less developed country which has little parkings and could not attend school, you can become a guard for cars set up in a large area of about 20 cars and charge a dollar for car. Sometimes they can give you up to $4 a car, and this is every 30 minutes for about 12 hours, which would give you about $500 for a day of doing basically nothing. Truckers. And no, not the cross-country truckers, which are kinda almost a minority. The drivers I'm talking about are the ones who are delivering to restaurants and whatnot. You can make $60,000 to $100,000 a year easily. But now that you think about it, yeah, this would expected be pay well, because imagine if all trucks stopped moving for one day. Edit. I obviously meant $60,000, not $60. Edited because of a smartass. Did you know people put gutters on their houses to catch the rain as it falls off the roof? I didn't either until a guy walked up to me and handed me a job doing it. Turns out making $300, $600 a day is an everyday thing doing it piece rate in Florida. School bus drivers. My grandfather was a school bus driver, and he says it pays surprisingly well. All you are doing is sitting on your ass driving around, and you get paid $30 an hour. However, you still have to clean the kids' slimy disgustingness afterwards. Funeral director is a great paying job with not a whole lot of schooling. That's what I do, and I make about $75,000. Bartending. Some people know, but the overwhelming majority don't. If I only work 20 hours, 2 days a week this year, weekends, I would make close to $50,000. If I really tried and worked two solid jobs 5 days a week, I would easily hit close to, if not over, $100,000. This doesn't apply to every bar or bartender. You're not going to make this type of money at an Applebee's or a super franchised corporate establishment. Working is logistics, warehouse, purchasing supplies, etc. I have been doing this for 8 years and have a master's degree in supply chain. It's super easy to me. All you really need to do is pay attention. Plus, it's great money. San Francisco Poop Patrol. A 10-person team. All they do is go around the city and clean up human feces, which is apparently a problem there. They make about $80,000 a year, plus pensions and benefits, which bring the total to about $150,000. Not even kidding. Let's go scoop poop. I'm 19 and I'm a manager at a trampoline park. Only make $15 an hour, but it's a ducking trampoline park. Document specialist for utilities. Basically, you have to know someone to get into it. But I went from making less than 40k as an office admin to 120k as a doc specialist. No college requirement. Often people just get their spouses or siblings on because they've worked in an office before. As a general rule, this is terrible for anyone who actually knows what they're doing in the job. But, like, whatever. A lot of times I'm just getting paid to hold down a desk. Sales. My last sales job, I was selling flooring. It took me about an hour to an hour and a half measuring each room and hallway. Talk with the homeowner to know what they want. We offered financing for everyone. All my leads were red hot. So everyone I was scheduled to meet with was ready to buy that day. Each sale was $5,000 and up. I had sales of over $20,000 and my commission check was anywhere from 5 to 25% of that sale. I even had up to 5 scheduled appointments a day. I have had days where I made 3 sales with an average commission of $500 each. Notary clerks. $30 for just signing a document and putting in register. My wife is a dental hygienist. Makes $48 HR. Lotta blue collar work is suddenly very profitable since everyone is a white collar worker now. The HVAC dude who used to come to my work to clean our furnaces made 6 figures and retired at 40. Now he lives in Mexico and teaches people to scuba dive. Teaching. Haha, just kidding. The pay sucks. On the flip side, working in IT pays terribly. Also was laughed at by a recruiter for insisting on a 9-5 hourly job. Guess my family will raise itself. Redbubble. There's probably a saying floating out there that goes wherever there are gullible people, there is profit. If not, then I just coined it. I've been putting memes on Redbubble and I'm making $200-$400 every month. I literally do nothing besides laughing at memes, putting them on a website, and waiting for people to buy it. This much money is enough for groceries or going out with the lads monthly. Train conductor on Long Island. Edit. Into on. Zamboni driving. In high school I was making like $27 HR and I needed 0 education aside from a few training shifts. I'm about to duck you up with some truth. Working for a rental car company as an agent. 60-100k. Can you type? Can you talk? Are you willing to sell just a little bit? Welcome. I'm a pet sitter and I make pretty good cash from it during the busy times, summer and holidays, for very little effort in some cases. I've been doing it for a few years now and after busting my ass and whoring my time out to clients and their critters, I've built a great client base and can relax a bit now. Of course I work a full-time job too. Pet sitting isn't steady enough to rely on, but I can make an extra $500-$600 a month when it's busy. It gets hectic figuring out the timing between the two jobs sometimes, but it's so worth it. I'm currently pet sitting for a week. $245 to hang out with 2 adorable dogs, eat their food, drink the wine they bought me, and relax. I love what I do. I'm a gardener. There's a serious lack of folks willing to do manual labor in the outdoors year round. Most commercial properties have to maintain a certain amount of green area in our city. Hospitals and other places like that need legitimate crews to do the work with professionalism. No catcalling or spitting or swearing etc, including bonded employees and good insurance and equipment etc. As a result, we are in demand and we get paid surprisingly well. No university education needed. Low barrier to entry. Great pay and job security. It. Jobs that require extensive and expensive certifications. If you already blew what you had on college because your parents, teachers, counselors demanded you do so, there's nothing to see here. I wish more of these jobs were things a petite 20-something woman could get hired for lol. Becoming a locksmith changed my life. Well paid and I get to help people out, I love it. Reading all this is making me depressed. I have to wake up to a ratty job tomorrow. I need to find something else. I just don't know what. Ugh. Electric lineman. It's potentially dangerous work and you need to be comfortable with working in heights and in crappy weather. But you can easily make $200k in your first year and they'll train you to do the job. If I was a young guy starting out, I'd be all over that career path. Edit. If you live in California and Nevada and would like a path forward in this career, then check these guys out. There is this job that was really popular with high schoolers during the summer where I grew up, where the city hired you to just hang out at the river and pick up trash and keep watch for shenanigans. It was a really simple job and mostly the kids treated it like a party but actually picked up after themselves for a change. At the time, minimum wage was like $10 to $12 an hour. That job paid $18 I think. Granted, it was a summer job and part-time, but still good pay to duck around at the river all day with your friends. The year I got out of high school, I picked up a job at a private country club working the bag room. When I spotted a member, I'd grab their reserved private cart from the garage and load their clubs on it that they kept stored in the bag room. couple damp towels hung on the back, pencils, scorecards and everything waiting by the time they stepped up. Place was primarily executives and whatnot for like the major automotive companies here in Michigan. I made a couple hundred each day in tips. During a couple tournaments that took place, I went home with around $500 in my pocket. I took home so much each day that I kept forgetting to pick up my paycheck, which was something like another $400 each week, late 90s minimum wage. Only part of the job I hated was using the picker to get the balls off the range. There was always some ass bag trying to use me for target practice. Every one of the top comments requires some sort of training. But here it is. Washing cars. Can you hold a sponge? You're hired. You get on in an upper class suburb. You can make 50k a year easy. All the OT you can take. And that 50k is before tips. Which can be quite generous if you work hard and are at least semi-personable. Those terrible kids shows on YouTube. Millions of views and subscribers translates to millions of dollars. Taking a, it. Garbage collector. Edit. Spelling and actually now I'm not so sure IDK. Court stenographer. With a sideline of subtitle writer.